we've got a short somewhere in the system. Pop fuse. What I'm going to do now. Let's insert this here short pro. Make sure I'm not getting close to any of this stuff. See, it's only happening in cooling mode. The reason we know is because it's got 0 ohms resistance. Your ohms resistance shows that it's a direct short. And continuity alone isn't enough to know. Because usually if it was just the, being in circuit from like a transformer or something, you'd have at least some resistance, 12, 15 ohms or something like that. But 0 to me, direct short. Let's see what we're working on here. These tips off of here, shoot. Check the contactor. Yeah, there you go. Contactor. See that? Got 0 ohms. Good contactor should have some resistance, some resistance in that winding. Okay, I'm letting them get a price. Okay, so just in case you didn't see, let me ohm it out, contactor. Take all the terminals, all the connectors off, you'll see 0 ohms, 0.1 ohms. That was 0 before. Now we take the new contactor. So the internal windings, once again, are shorted out on this thing. Okay. Yes, I've already got the power off. You know, I always like to check the voltage. We already checked, pushed the contactor in, but don't get too used to this stuff, man. You always want to make sure. Just don't get too comfortable. That's what I like to try to exercise, because electricity is no joke. Make sure you just don't get any stray fibers. Just keep it all in the actual terminal. Beautiful. Okay. Like I always say, I always like to work as if it's my first time ever doing a part, ever, you know, replacing or working on something. Always take pictures, always, you know, kind of work in reverse order. Eey, that's not good. Jeez. I need some more slack on that. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's perfect. So you always like to try to, you know, just treat it as if I don't know what I'm doing that way. This makes it a lot less stressful. I always like to twist the wire nuts, just, you know, give enough of a twist to where the wire completely wraps around. Just where they wrap around one another and holds the wire nut on there. Let's see here. Not there. Two more wires. That literally just do one at a time. That's it. Not too proud. Yeah, you can see the burnout. Look at that. You usually don't catch that. It's pretty cool. See if you can see that. Interesting. Oh yeah, I'm gonna pop that back on. I'm just gonna put this fuse back in.
So we blew a fuse.
Yes, ma'am.
And then.
All right, so I got that figured out. It's up and running here now. So I'm about to just check my volts, my pressures and temperatures, amp draw, power factor, and everything. Make sure everything is running up to spec. As usual, gotta use Measure Quick. Don't have to use it, but I love it, so I'm gonna use it. See if we're starting to get a split here. Yeah, it's cooling a little so far. Let's go ahead and connect our, oops. First things first, we're gonna go ahead and connect our gauges. Zero them out. Zero out our smart probes to ambient. See how they got, right now it's showing 5 PSI, 1.4 PSI. That's unnecessary, so we'll just zero it so you can start from a clean slate. Suction on, suction. What I like to do is get all the specs here. That's going to be model number. That's a 2-ton piston. Well, the indoor is actually a TXV, pretty certain. So I'll double check that though. Let's see here. Home, system info, split system, scroll, 2-ton, TXV, continue. Here, outdoor temperature, same 50 warmest. Let's just say 53. Liquid line probes out here. All right. Never fails, man. Look, I just put fresh batteries in these things, man. Well, no, I didn't put them in this. Put it in the actual. Let's see. Yep. So we need batteries. Got up with these things. Someone needs to make the type you can recharge or just USB and be done with it. Sick of these placing batteries. No, I wasn't going to litter. Far 18 degree temp split. We got a return dry bulb temperature 66 degrees, which is a little on the low side, just for cooling. Return relative humidity 45 is decent. Wet bulb 53, supply temperature 47, supply relative humidity is 69, the wet bulb's 42. So, and that's still climbing, as you can see, it's slightly climbing still. 19 now, so super is pretty high though. Let's see, let's let it run for a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna check our power factor, fan efficacy. I'll go to electrical, split, single phase, condensing units 230, 240, evaporating coil is actually also going to be 240, RCM motor. Okay. Let's go ahead and capture our voltage and amps on the compressor. I always like to just use one hand, that way the current doesn't try to flow through your chest cavity. Oh, nice. Decent power factor, 0.97. 960 watts. It's pretty decent. I'm going to go ahead and do here. Continue. Nice. Starting to fall right into place, all the temperatures and pressures. I'm going to show you one of the real reasons why I love this measure quick along with the smart fish, the Subco Redfish here meter, for checking amps and volts and stuff like that. So you see here, I gotta capture this. I need my I definitely am going to have to invest in the field piece. Field piece probes, because this testo range is just absolutely ridiculous. I've got the S-Man 480s, but I don't like to use those for just general servicing, right? Just a little bit unnecessary. It's a lot of loss in the lines of those things. A lot of refrigerant loss. Let's see, are you only going to capture that? Alright, so now I'm just going to go ahead and check the capacitor. Basically make sure it's within plus or minus a 5% tolerance of the sticker rating. So we got a 5x40. I can just check the voltage too on this thing. I always want to check. 0 volts. Hermetic is blue. Common is yellow. You can usually tell the common because it goes straight back to the one of the legs of the contactor. Usually brown fan. And so what we're gonna do. Go across common and hermetic, and I've got, I don't like this meter because it takes so long, 39, which is good. Common and fan, like such. It takes like 5 seconds to register. It's 39x5. That's perfect. Yellow to common, as we had it. Hermetic is blue. And brown was the fan wire. Sear. Total system capacity. Here we go. pretty nice day out. So make sure you go ahead and like and subscribe. We'll catch you on the next one, yeah? Bye now.